Good morning, Puna Penguins. You're watching the KPG Penguin News Now with your host, Era. Today is Wednesday, April 17th, 2024. It is our 136th day of school. There are 44 days left to go after today. 136 is our number of the day. Can you think of ways to make the number 136? Here's the way I thought of. 100 plus 30 plus 6 equals 136. The weather for today looks to be sunny with a high of 67 degrees. Today is Wacky Wednesday, and one wacky fact is, did you know that some fish can cough? Weird but true. It helps in the cleaning of the gills of accumulated and particulate matter. Fishes can even yawn and burp. That's pretty wacky. Now let's turn things over to Colette.
Hi, my name is Colette and I'm your second host for the day. There are no penguin birthdays today. Did you know that today is International Bat Appreciation Day? This is a chance to show our flying and mostly nocturnal friends some love. Today is an opportunity to delve deep and learn the important role bats play in the ecosystem and biodiversity. There are over 1,400 different bat species, and contrary to the popular opinion, they aren't blind. So, without further ado, let's creep a little deeper into the cave and take a closer look at International Bat Appreciation Day and everything these flying mammals have to offer. Now, we'll hand things over to Lake.
Hi, penguins. It's me, Lake, another one of your hosts for today. It's time for announcements about what's happening around the school. Read to Feed continues. Please bring in food to help restock the local food pantries and bring in your completed cards. First thing in the morning to earn your bracelets. Quarter choir rehearse after school today. On this day in history in 1964, Geraldine Mock became the first woman to fly solo around the world. Here's our funny joke for the week. Why can't a rabbit's nose be 12 inches long? Because then it would be a foot. Next, we'll hand things over to Felix to end our broadcast.
Good morning, penguins. We are up here at the Lost and Found, and the rack is super, super duper full. So we need to come by, take a quick look, a careful look, see if anything belongs to you on the rack. We have some water bottles and lunches up on top and a couple hats. So if you see anything that belongs to you, come and get it.
Hello, penguins. I'm Felix and I'm your final host for today. In the recent news, between now and September, NASA predicts an even rarer celestial event than the solar eclipse, a nova outburst. Unlike the eclipse, this phenomenon can be observed from anywhere on Earth without using special equipment. A nova only occurs in binary star systems consisting of a dying star, typically a large red giant, and a dead star, also known as the white dwarf. Since two stars orbit in sync, the material shed by the red giant accumulates on the surface of the white dwarf. Eventually, the gathered material explodes in a burst of energy known as a nova. It results in a sudden and dramatic increase of brightness, illuminating the night skies. Usually, these events can only be seen through powerful telescope, but in the upcoming Cornea Borealis nova eruption will be visible with the unaided eye. NASA expects the nova explosion to occur sometime before summer 2024, but the exact timing is hard to determine. Please remember to say the Pledge of Allegiance with your class sometime today. Let's all show our penguin pride by being safe, respectful, responsible, and kind. This is Felix saying goodbye from the Penguin News.